Good evening. I'm Ruth Cabal in for Mitzi Borromeo. Transport authorities filed a plunder complaint against top officials of the previous administration of Noynoy Aquino, including key Liberal Party stalwarts. Our Rex Remitio gives us the reason for the filing of the case.
A grand conspiracy to steal billions of pesos in taxpayers' money at the expense of Metro Rail transit commuters. That's how the Transportation Department describes what high-ranking officials of the Aquino administration did.
This is actually in response to the public clamor and cry for accountability for the dismal state of our train system, specifically the MRT3.
The DOTR filed a plunder complaint before the ombudsman against 9 secretaries in the cabinet of former President Aquino. The main culprits, former Transportation Secretary Jun Abaya and his predecessor Marrojas. Both are stalwarts of Aquino's Liberal Party. The other cabinet officials are accused of tolerating the acts of Abaya and Rojas. Also included in the complaint are 10 other former transportation officials, 10 officials of the Busan Universal Rail, the SAC maintenance provider of MRT3, and Marlo de la Cruz, who is said to be connected to the LP and with both former maintenance providers, PH Trams and Global APT.
Buo sila, kaya conspiracy ho to. Bilang sa conspiracy, so act of one is an act of all.
In the complaint, the DOTR says Abaya and Rojas used the MRT3 project to acquire ill-gotten wealth. They say it was also a bottomless cash cow for the party. The complaint claims Abaya terminated former MRT maintenance contractor Sumitomo despite its good record and replaced it with the dummy corporation, PH Trams Joint Venture. Abaya entered into a 500 million peso contract with PH Trams without public bidding. PH Trams is apparently not registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission. When the anomaly was exposed, Abaya and his officials abruptly replaced PH Trams with Global APT, again with no public bidding for an almost 700 million peso contract. Instead, it used the aging rail tracks from Light Rail Transit 2 for MRT3. The DOTR says this caused the consecutive broken rail failures of the MRT and led to the derailment of a train in the Edsataf Avenue station that injured 3 dozen passengers. Officials say all these happened because of the deliberate inaction of former transport officials. The DOTR also blames Abaya and other respondents for the wasteful purchase of light rail vehicles from Dalian and signaling systems from Bombardier Transportation. These deliberate mistakes culminated in the contract with Busan Universal Rail, although the company is not technically, legally, and financially capable to operate the project.
For the past 8 months, from the start of the contract of Buri, binayaran ho nilang Buri buwan, every month, by 54 million. Wala hong deduction yon.
Abaya and his team failed to submit the required documents for the payments under the law, since the amount is above 50 million pesos, which the DOTR says is tantamount to plunder. Rex Remitio, CNN, Philippines.